8th of April, 1943. This is video number 12, Let's Play USA. Video number 11 stopped with me invading Norway. And that's exactly where this video is gonna take up. I just wanted to let that run so it would update all the production sliders and needs and so forth and so on. I am not gonna play at that speed. Okay, we'll set it on speed 3. Check out the Pacific. Can't remember if I had updated. I did update this transport fleet with assault ships. And I'm actually going to move this to speed 4 since the Germans aren't doing anything at the moment. Him to stay put and come down here and take Stavanger. I want to check and see if they're going to be out in September. Okay. In the meantime, I'm going to take the second mechanized and see if I can take Oslo. Notice I give the fleet the move order, not the invasion order, because I want to manually order them to invade. Sometimes the invasion order doesn't work properly, so over the years I've just come to automatically use the move order, move the fleet to the C zone I want them to be in, and then I manually put the units. And also doing it this way, you could select, like when I see that this unit is going in unopposed, I'm going to pause that unit and tell it to go in here. And that way it will slow down that one German unit that's trying to go back into Oslo while the rest of the units take Oslo on. And here we have the a little battle here with Finland. Looks like they've got... Well, they're not going to last very long, I can tell you that. We lost none, that's what we like to see. Okay, this is really nice because this is a max size port. Now again, if you watched earlier, you'll remember I'm playing with manual control of convoys. So I will need to create a convoy from... Actually, I'm going to go from Boston. From Boston to Oslo. And generally, there is no rhyme or reason to the way this adds up, but if you have just captured a port, it's generally the very last port on the list, if that helps you out when you're looking. Ports that you just captured are usually, actually, they're always the last one on the list. So I've created the convoy, now I need to add units to it, and again, pressing control and left clicking adds 10. And I'm going to add 10 escorts also. Okay, and then we'll just make sure that, there we go, convoy into both areas. Now that I've got this unit here, I want to come down here and clear out. What happens, the reason I do this is the Germans can cross here into Sweden. They have a treaty with Sweden that allows them to move across their land. So what they do is they come across Sweden and they enter Norway. However, they cannot enter Norway if I've already captured the border provinces. So what I try to do is capture these as quickly as I can so that any German units that do move over here are way up here and I'm able to dictate how much supply they get. Because as they're moving across, they lose organization and supply levels. All right, so we just want to move this, just keep this going. Also want to make sure that we got things going here. Now I'm going to see if I can get, if I've got some TAC bombers, because it's good practice. There we go. Good practice. Right now, there doesn't appear to be a German fighter threat. Now, there will be. There's no doubt in my mind, since, again, remember, the Russians are out of the picture. And I'm going to, this is going to be attack wing. I always name these so that when I'm looking at them over here later, I can see, like, this is a multi-role. Of course, it hasn't updated yet because I've got the game paused. But at any rate, I'm going to first move them to Scapa Flow. Because I do not want them flying across Europe here at all. Because there's no doubt in my mind the Germans would... All right, here we got a naval attack going on here. Now, I've bring my interceptors over. And intercept. That will add two. Now, there's something I want to point out here. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, well, it's not an issue right now, but what I was going to point out is I see some people posting in the forums, both on the Paradox forums and in Steam, in the past that their fleets are being attacked and their fighters from their carriers are not doing anything. And the reason for that being is sometimes you'll see an icon here that looks like a jack-in-the-box popping up, and that's a surprise icon. When your fleets are surprised, your fighters don't have time to engage the enemy bombers. In this case, that's not the case, and as you can see, my fighters are actually engaging the enemy bombers, both the CAG and the interceptors. But now that we've got that where we need it to be, in other words, I'm moving this transport fleet out, and I'm going to move the carrier fleet and the surface action fleet out of the area. Let's see what Australia, they want the A-26 Invader, and of course they can have it. Am I still, yes, I'm still getting the officer ratio up. Now that I've got, I'm going to move the tactical wing here. And I'm going to move the interceptor here. Of course, it will take a while for them to gain their organization back, but I'd rather have the interceptor closer to Germany and have the tactical bombers where they can reach much further up north. I'm going to go ahead and have him run down here, capture this port, because what I don't want is the Germans using any of these four ports here. And now we've got a little bit of excess. Yeah. So let's see. I want to take a gander at how many aircraft we have. All right, so 8 fighters, which is the multi-role, 8 interceptors, which is good, 5 strategic and 6 TAC. Only got 2 NAV, 5 strategic and 6 TAC. What's in production as far as aircraft are concerned? Nothing is what I believe. And that is correct. Well, since I only have 2 strategic bombers, I'm going to add 2 more. I like to use those in groups of 4. I'm going to move them to the top. This stuff here is not... Actually, I'm going to go ahead and move the Bergen, or the Norway stuff up to the top, since that's an active combat theater right now. Thank you. Now I'm going to use the Patton, the second army commander, to come up here and take these little provinces that there's no Germans in. I just need them filled out. So he's not exactly a combat unit, but he will capture provinces if they're uncontested. So I can keep using my combat units to do what I need them to do. Since he's ahead, I'll have him go ahead and capture this. Yeah. I do remember wanting to put some additional defenses in Gibraltar, but it looks like as expected, the UK is probably controlling the Med since they still have access here. Now, I don't imagine Italy has much left, although we did look, I think it was the last video, and I couldn't find a whole lot of British naval units. I'm not sure where they are all at, but they seem to be doing okay. They can move around at will. I'm not sure why they lost all this. I am pleased, of course, that it happened, because it makes the game interesting. But they don't seem to be doing a whole lot at the moment, and I don't think it's lack of trying. Remember, again, with Russia out of the picture, the Germans have the entire army to work with and their allies. All right, now we want to, and I apologize for the shakiness when I'm moving, scrolling in and out. I have a Rat 7 in it. I think it has gone, I've had it for several years, so I think it's about shot. The scroll wheel doesn't function properly. But I tried using I have a bunch of other mice laying around here, but I just can't go back to a regular mouse now. That this high DPI, moving around with a regular mouse takes forever to get from one side of the screen to the other, even when you're on max movement speed. So I'll put up with it for now. Looks like they're really sending naval bombers out here, and that gives me an idea that if I've got some multi-rolls, I can move over, and perhaps while I am assisting the Brits in defense, I can be, I think I will, well, let's try them here. I will be leveling, getting some experience for my fighters. Alright, let's set that to Norway. Make sure I did that. Yep. Okay. We'll let them build up supply since I just got here and there was no units here before that were using any. Boy, Britain is pretty much, they don't have any. Their defense force is really inadequate, in my opinion. But I guess, again, as long as they can keep the Germans at bay from a naval standpoint, they don't really have to have a large buildup of forces in their home. All right. Once I've got Trondheim, normally, and I apologize if I'm really butchering that name, but normally from that point on, that's where I'll slow down and consolidate. I'll use one core. No, I don't want to do that. All right, so I've got 9 extra. I'll use one core to hold both of these two large ports here, this one and this one, and then I will consolidate the second core here. Once they're all here, I'll then push forward with portions of, which I believe in this case is going to be the second. Oh, I misspelled mechanized, didn't I? I didn't misspell it. I just forgot to delete that second letter from earlier. Okay. The second mechanized corps will consolidate here. The first is going to hold Oslo and Bergen, which will be this unit here. And the entire second is going to go up here. All right, now the Pacific. I wanted to check and see if I have some extra. All right, so these are the transports from earlier that came from the transport fleet that is now in Norway. I want to see how many. I have 153 total ships, which means I can get rid of these transports. I don't need them as a draw any longer on supply and fuel. So we'll take some assault ships. Now the Pacific Theater doesn't need as large a force as far as assault ships are concerned, but I will send the same size fleet, a fleet of six. And it's simple because the units I'm going to use in the Pacific are all regular infantry with some anti-tank and artillery as opposed to mechanized. So they just don't take up as much transport space. It's just as simple as that. I'm going to base him in Norway. At Norway. Norfolk. And again, holding down the shift key while I have a unit selected, and then right-clicking on provinces allows you to select a path for your unit. And they will just continue moving on. Now I want to come back here, unless this was the one that was... Okay, so the Eckelberger has got one division that's down here, so I can go ahead and move Collins out. I want Collins to come all the way up here. And I want this unit to go ahead and capture all this territory before he also comes back to Oslo. And we can see that the carrier and the battleship or the surface action group are up to full repairs and organization again. So what I want to do is come down here, blockade here, see if there's anything. Sometimes you won't see naval fleets in a port with ground units. So I move the naval units here, and especially with the carrier, you'll be able to see. All right, we've got 13 more excess. I'm going to throw in... Actually, I'm going to throw in some transport planes. Just one for now. I'm going to leave it at the bottom. All right, it doesn't look like there are any actual ships here. So let's go check up here. Ah, now we've got a German headquarters, which means that I've got a target for my tactical teams. Let's see what they can do here on ground attack. If nothing else, it should get them some experience. And since this is not contested, I'm going to go ahead and take this port. Now, what was I doing back here? All right, this is the... I want to take these guys and actually put them here in San Diego, because I'm going to swap out this transport fleet that's already in San Diego, and I'm going to give them also assault ships. Now, I can see that my officer ratio is back where I need it to be. I can switch back to actually doing research now. While all this is going on, let me check what's going on in the Pacific. We know Australia has already fallen. For all intents and purposes, Japan owns New Zealand. Looks like they've cleaned up everything. They annexed the Philippines, of course. This right here, I don't know about. They're pushing, wow, they're pushing down into, yeah, look at this. I've already got Diego Garcia. All right, let's see what just came out of. Ah, garrison brigades. I'm going to plop them down in Los Angeles. Go ahead and give them a commander defense. In this case, I'm just going to give them the highest level ones that I can. And if I need to change later around, I will. Just leave them there to soak up some organization. And I took a lot. Just need the self-propelled artilleries to come out. And the first army will be complete, as I pointed out. But I'm going to start on the second army. The second mechanized army. Two mechanized, armored car, self-propelled artillery will be the command. I'm going to start on one corps, which will be the 5th mechanized corps. That will be the command headquarters unit right there. And then adding a tank destroyer will complete the corps with 5 divisions underneath it. And that all will be the 5th mechanized corps. I'll move them to the top. And we'll go back and see nothing here going on in Norway. Okay. Aero engine, which is a good thing. 45. It is now 43, so I'm going to go another level. I'm going to stick with aircraft and go another level. There's it, infantry, or garrison brigade. I should say division, shouldn't I? All right. Now, Patton, sitting still. We don't want him sitting still. We want him to continue capturing these areas over here that are untested. That way I can just keep my actual combat units doing what they need to do. Industry production. That brings me up to 44. That's enough. I want to go back to industry efficiency. Got some garrison divisions here. I'm going to plop these down on the East Coast, right here, New York, because what's going to happen is I'm going to send these. You know, earlier I said I would change. I'm going to do that right now, change these commanders, because I want the level 2 commanders for these guys. And the reason that is I'm going to send these. I'm going to send at least one of them to Gibraltar, because it's very important that we keep Gibraltar, we being the Allies. And I just don't have confidence in the UK having that protected very well. Especially since they've lost the Suez Canal. Medium tank engine, up to 42. What is its speed now? 7. Mechanized is still 9. Alright. We'll let it run again. And it looks like we got some action going on. Oh, this. I may have to swap this mouse out after all. Here we go. Mechanized offensive. What does that bring it up to? 43. I'm going to let that continue. Another garrison division. We're going to plop on In New York also. These other garrison divisions, I've got a right mind to plop them down in the UK proper on a couple of ports here. But we'll see. I may wind up plopping them down in Norway. Because what I want to do. All right, he's already totally destroyed that headquarters division. What I want to do actually is invade North Africa. But I want to wait until the. Definitely want to leave interception on. Let's go ahead and swap this out while I'm thinking about it. We want to put in the assault ships and take out the transports. All right. And what I'll do is I'll leave Stark here, and he'll just be a general transport fleet, transporting units as needed from the West Coast out into the Pacific. And Kincaid will be the actual combat transport unit, which means I'm going to base him in Hawaii. This is interesting. I wonder where all the. Imagine the bulk. You see here now the. It looks like the Brits have been stopped, although they may be pushing this entire stack out here. And we're coming to a close, 3 minutes left in this video. I'm not going to get to the point. I'm going to bring this assault fleet. Assault fleet. Okay. Fighter ground control, we'll leave it. This transport fleet back to Boston. Because I'm going to use the third mechanized to attack into North Africa. Again, I want this to be offensive doctrine, and I try to put level threes as a minimum in all my core commander positions. I save the fours and above for army level and above. And I'll try to put ones underneath because they gain experience much faster. All right. I have him move back. There. And it looks like we've all but got this wrapped up as far as Norway is concerned. Go ahead. No, we'll go ahead and move him there. Patton will continue to get the rest of these here. I'm going to go ahead and send these two to start taking the rest of Norway. Now, one thing that I do that others may not do is I'm not going to liberate Norway because I'm going to keep it for its manpower and resources. People will, the min-maxers will say, yeah, but you're an occupied area, so you don't get the same amount of resources, so forth and so on. It doesn't matter. If it's one resource more than I got before, that's more resources. That's just the way I look at it, very simplistically. And it doesn't cost me. And later, you'll see another thing I do that really sets people off. But, I don't care. It's just the way I prefer to do it. All right, well, I'm going to stop the video here.